Chicago's debatably the biggest winner of the offseason so far, as the additions of the Big Baller, the Caruso, and now Debo have significantly boosted their talent. These moves are further proof that the organization's in win-now mode, given they traded for Vucevic back at the deadline. Caruso and Ball give Chi-Town two likable players who can get out in transition and are exceptional defenders. DeRozan gives them another go-to scorer they can count on next to Zach LaVine. The Bulls are all in for 2021-22. Stay tuned to see how much better they'll be and how all their new pieces fit together. Before continuing, over three quarters of the people who watch this channel are not subscribed, so if you're looking for consistent NBA content, you're in the right place. Follow me on Instagram at DFlowHoops as well. I post channel updates on there as well as highlights. The Bulls finished this past year 11th in the East at 31-41, two games behind Charlotte for the final play-in spot. They missed the playoffs for a fourth straight year, and even after trading for Nikola Vucevic in late March, the team couldn't string together wins consistently. But with a talent like Zach LaVine in the prime of his career, you can't waste any more seasons. You have to go for it. And at the very least, the deal for Vooch displayed that the storied franchise was trying to compete. Now with their moves in the first few days of free agency, it's evident that the Bulls have doubled down on their commitment to being good again. First, the Bulls picked up Lonzo Ball in a sign-and-trade with the New Orleans Pelicans. A few hours after that, they reached a deal with fan favorite and defensive-minded guard Alex Caruso. A day later, Chicago's front office made its biggest splash, acquiring DeMar DeRozan in another sign-and-trade deal. We'll get to the full details on those three massive signings and how they fit next to Chicago's franchise player. Today's game is run by multi-talented athletic guards who can operate in the pick and roll, and now the Bulls have five guys who can do that. LaVine, DeRozan, Ball, Caruso, and Kobe White are all capable creators you can rely on. A starting lineup consisting of Lonzo, DeMar, LaVine, 2020's number four pick Patrick Williams, and Nikola Vucevic will surely win the Bulls more than 31 games in 2022, but how good can they be? You'll hear about that later on. Let's get into what you came here for, the Bulls' three big-time free agent pickups. Since his days at Chino Hills, Lonzo Ball's been the center of attention. Zo's flashy playstyle, in addition to what his dad LaVar Ball was saying on national TV, put a target on his back from day one.
You were on record talking about put your son on the Golden State Warriors.
Yes.
And put Steph Curry on UCLA.
Yes.
And your son would explain how
right
your son
now. Would be better. Right now.
Right now.
Right now. Now. UCLA wouldn't be where they at. Steph Curry gonna shoot him out the game. He ain't rebounding and passing that ball.
Shoot him out the game.
Shoot him out shoot the game.
A target which greatly intensified once reaching the pros, especially considering the large market he was drafted into. Selected second overall by the Lakers out of UCLA in 2017, Ball's altered his shooting mechanics and greatly improved his efficiency from three-point range in every year up to this point. He's become a much different player since his move to New Orleans as part of a blockbuster deal that sent Anthony Davis to LA. Ball hit a career-high 172 three-pointers last season while making a career-best 37.8% of his shots from deep. Given he took 8.3 deep-range shots per game, that's a pretty decent percentage. A four-year pro who turns 24 in a few months and was just a restricted free agent, Ball's coming off his best season. His second year in the Big Easy saw him post career-best totals in points per game with 14.6, and field goal percentage at 41.4. He also dished out 5.7 assists per game. And right at the start of 2021 free agency, it was reported that Ball had earned himself a four-year, $85 million deal. Lonzo goes from suiting up next to a rising phenom in Zion to joining Olympian Zach LaVine, four-time All-Star DeMar DeRozan, and two-time All-Star Nikola Vucevic. Whether it's at Chino, UCLA, or the pros, Lonzo's developed a reputation for his passing and unorthodox three-point trigger that he somehow gets to fall, but his defense is underrated. Ball's never going to get big-bodied as he's really good at fighting through screens, so can Zo live up to expectations and get the Bulls to the playoffs? That's coming up. But onto the acquisition of the GOAT. While Lonzo had a relatively smooth journey to the NBA, conversely, Alex Caruso went undrafted back in 2016, and he had to work his way up through the G League. He was never supposed to stick around in the NBA, But mere minutes after the Bulls signed Lonzo, they locked up Caruso to a four-year, $37 million deal, a steal of a contract for Chicago, given he's one of the better defensive guards in basketball. The physicality this man provides is for real. Not only is he strong as hell, but his lateral mobility's elite. Mix that strength and quickness with his awareness in the passing lanes and general IQ, and you can see why everyone calls him the GOAT. Caruso's strips and end-to-end jams provide an intensity that lit up Staples Center, and those momentum-changing sequences should have a similar effect at United Center in Chi-Town. Given he's won a championship, maybe Alex can provide some type of mentorship to the young Coby White. And on the floor, given Caruso's an unselfish, fluid ball handler, he should be able to take the pressure off Coby as well. White does have some serious internal competition, but Caruso's a pass-first type of player who should open up his game. Your starting backcourt will be Lonzo and DeRozan, with White and Caruso backing them up. So look for Coby and Alex to build up some chemistry. It's just great to see the Bulls organization finally get LaVine a viable roster. The sign and trade that became official yesterday was the Bulls signing of four-time All-Star and former All-NBA player DeMar DeRozan to a three-year, $85 million deal. The Spurs acquired Thaddeus Young, Al-Farouq Aminu, and a future first-round pick. It's the veteran scorer's third team in the NBA following 10 years in San Antonio and Toronto, and he'll be hungry to bring the Bulls not only to the playoffs but to a championship. DeRozan's mid-range scoring should complement LaVine's slashing and three-point shooting, and the man's ability to get buckets at will should open up a lot more space on the floor for Zach to go to work. And vice versa, LaVine's probably the best player DeRozan's ever played with, so DeMar should have an easier time. DeMar put up 22 points, 6 dimes, on 49.5% shooting from the field last year. There were rumors DeRozan would end up in Miami, but good on Chicago's front office for snatching him up early in free agency. But will Chicago make the playoffs next year? Let's talk about it. Keep in mind, the East is going to be a lot more competitive than it has been for the previous decade. The Sixers, Nets, Bucks, Heat, Hawks, and Celtics are almost a guarantee to take up 6 of the 8 playoff spots out East. But after a 27-5-5 season from LaVine last year, it was clear the Bulls had a superstar on their hands and all they needed was the right roster around him to make things work. Zach nearly joined the 50-40-90 club last year, coming up 5 free throw percentage points away from doing that. He's elevated his reputation for much more than just a 2-time dunk champ. He's a bona fide top-notch scorer. 2021 saw him become the only player in the league to play at least 50 games and average 25 points on shooting splits of 50-40-80. He became the first Bull in franchise history to make at least 200 three-pointers in a season. He posted 6 20-point quarters, second only to Steph Curry, and 25 30-point games, 2 ahead of Joel Embiid for number 6 in the league. Now LaVine's got a bit more help. I'd relate this to the Bucks situation when they acquired Drew Holiday, because before Milwaukee had Drew, Giannis had to create everything in the pick and roll and always handle the ball. Holiday took the pressure off Giannis, similarly to how DeRozan, Lonzo, and Caruso will take the pressure off LaVine. Specifically, the all-star shot creation of DeMar is going to open up the floor for Zach, and even though Ball or Caruso aren't at the level of Drew Holiday, they can still generate offense for the Bulls, which will allow LaVine to take more possessions off. Yes, the three players Chicago signed thrive with the ball in their hands, just like LaVine, but now it's not all on one guy, like it has been for so many years with the Bulls. And it's not like Ball, Caruso, or DeRozan aren't good working off the ball. So, I think the Bulls are the number 5 or number 6 seed in 2022. Vucevic should thrive with the playmaking of Lonzo and Caruso, and LaVine's stamina will sustain itself throughout games better than it has in years past. So what seed will the Bulls be in 2022 in your opinion? Top answer in the comments section gets next video shout out. For today, Marcos Martinez gets the shout out for saying he likes Lowry in Miami and that Lowry's a bulldog and a leader who's definitely going to fit in well with the Heat's identity. This was D-Flow. Have a great one, and I'll see you next video.